Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Demystifying Medicine. Today, we will be covering the roles and responsibilities of anesthesiologists. There are many questions surrounding the field of anesthesia and many common misconceptions about what an anesthesiologist actually does. Some examples include, isn't anesthesiology just administering anesthesia? Do anesthesiologists just sit around all day? Do surgeons direct anesthesia care? Do anesthesiologists take a lot of breaks? And lastly, do anesthesiologists stay in the room for the entirety of the operation? While many people may only consider the roles of anesthesiologists in surgical care, it is important to consider their role in chronic pain as they have a significant background in managing pain. In the video's next section, we'll be hearing from the chair and professor of the anesthesiology department at McMaster University, Dr. James Paul. He has been working in the field of anesthesiology for the past 20 years and has experience in both the chronic pain and surgical roles of the job. What are the roles of an anesthesiologist pre-surgery?
My name is Dr. James Paul. I'm an anesthesiologist at McMaster University. An anesthesiologist is a medical specialist who in Canada does 5 years of residency training after medical school to be a consultant. Without anesthesiologists and the anesthesia they provide, surgeons would not be able to do the surgery that they plan to do. Prior to surgery, an anesthesiologist must assess the patient, do a full medical history, go through their past medical problems, their allergies, current medications, past experience with anesthesia, and relevant laboratory and radiological investigations. Based on a patient's medical status, decide on what type of anesthetic plan is appropriate, and in addition to the standard OR monitoring, what extra might be needed in terms of an arterial line, a central line, or maybe an epidural catheter. Preparing the patient for surgery involves instructing them on what medications to hold prior to surgery, which ones to take on the day of surgery, and tell them how long to fast, not eat or drink prior to surgery. Anesthesiologist takes fasting very seriously because aspiration of gastric contents into your lungs can be a life-threatening emergency, which we like to avoid at all cost. A patient signs a consent for the surgery, and that includes consent for the anesthesia interventions. So essentially, an anesthesiologist's role is to prepare the patient for surgery and anesthesia and make a plan that allows the patient to safely go through their surgery. And that plan includes a plan to manage their pain both during and after the surgery.
What are the roles of an anesthesiologist during surgery?
During the surgery, an anesthesiologist must provide the appropriate anesthetic for the patient. An anesthetic can be a general anesthetic where the patient is put right out. It can be a regional anesthetic, like an epidural or spinal, where they have a block where they don't feel the surgery and they can be awake or sedated, or they can have both a general anesthetic and a regional anesthetic. If the patient has a full general anesthetic, that involves bringing them to sleep with intravenous drugs or inhalational anesthesia, while they're asleep, putting a breathing tube or an endotracheal tube through their mouth through their vocal cords into their trachea, putting them onto a ventilator that's attached to the anesthetic machine, and then keeping them asleep with anesthetic gas that's delivered by the anesthetic machine. Besides keeping the patient asleep, the anesthesiologist also provides intravenous fluids to make up for the fact that the patient has been fasting for several hours prior to the surgery, is losing fluids in third spacing and with blood loss during the surgery. And besides fluid, sometimes the anesthesiologist has to transfuse blood, depending on how much blood is lost and what the patient's hemoglobin was to start with. Besides being asleep, sometimes the patient is also paralyzed. This is sometimes necessary for the patient to, when the surgeon has to access the abdominal cavity or the thoracic cavity, which requires paralysis. Besides paralysis, an analgesia is a very important part of anesthesia. To provide analgesia, intravenous opioids like fentanyl are often given. Besides opioids, you can use regional anesthesia. Surgery is done. The next big step is to wake the patient up after a general anesthetic. That's called emergence. This can be a risky part of an anesthetic because you can face complications like laryngospasm, apnea, and aspiration. So at this time, the anesthesiologist has to watch the patient closely, be vigilant, and be prepared to recognize any issues and prevent any complications before they happen. After the patient is awake and breathing on their own, the endotracheal tube is removed, the patient is extubated and transferred to a stretcher, and then transferred to the post-anesthesia care unit where they're monitored closely by nurses trained to deal with people acutely postoperatively.
What are the roles of an anesthesiologist post-surgery?
When the patient is transferred to the post-anesthetic care unit, or the PACU, they are handed over to the recovery room nurse. This handover includes a description of what surgery they had, the anesthetic they received, how much blood loss there was, how much fluid they were given, and what was given for analgesia so far. Any problems or complications that occurred in the surgery are described. So the anesthesiologist remains responsible for the patient while they're in the recovery room. They write orders that includes medications for pain, fluid management, investigations, and standard orders to deal with things like hypo and hypertension. The patient stays in the recovery room until they meet what's called a discharge criteria. The discharge criteria includes stable vital signs, appropriate pain control, and the ability to ambulate and go to the washroom. After the recovery room, if the patient's being admitted to hospital, they're transferred to the ward. If they're going home, they go back to patient receiving for a short period before they're discharged from the hospital.
What are the roles of an anesthesiologist in chronic pain care?
Anesthesiologists and other physicians sometimes specialize in chronic pain medicine. These physicians learn how to do complex care for people with complex pain needs. These pain management doctors devote their time and expertise to helping people with chronic pain that can be difficult to diagnose and can take months or years to treat using multiple therapies. These pain management doctors often treat things like low back pain, knee pain, other joint pain, neck pain. The common conditions include arthritis, fibromyalgia, migraine, sciatica, and more. The challenging thing with chronic pain is you can often improve someone's pain and quality of life and function, but you're not very often able to cure their pain, and it's something they have to learn how to live with long term.
To conclude the video, we wanted to provide a quick overview of some of the things covered. Before surgery, anesthesiologists meet with you and your surgeon to assess your health and make decisions to ensure your care is safe and effective. During surgery, they monitor your vital signs, including how well your heart and lungs are working while you're unconscious. After surgery, they take care of you and make sure you're as comfortable as possible while you recover. Anesthesiologists also play a key role in taking care of patients who are having minor surgery or who may not require general anesthesia, such as women in labor who need to be awake and alert but require effective pain management. Lastly, they also help patients who have serious pain from an injury or chronic or recurring pain, such as migraines or ongoing back problems. Created using Powtoon.